Today, I'm going to be taking a look at Poker Pretty Girls Battle Fantasy World Edition for the PlayStation 4. But just so you know, it is also available on the Nintendo Switch. So this is the most recent budget waifu game from the Zoo Corporation and East Asia Soft partnership. I've played their previous two console games on this channel, Bishoujo Cyber Panic and Mahjong Solitaire. I liked both of them. Poker is not usually my jam, but I've been trying to challenge myself to play genres of games that I normally wouldn't gravitate to. However, these mammoth mammaries must have enough mass to form their own gravitational field because I am being pulled in. By the way, don't try to use that line on real women, it won't work. Although you could use that as sort of a Turing test to see if someone online is a bot or if they're real. If it's a bot, they'll totally be into it. If it's a real woman, you'll get blocked. But hey, at least you'll know. What were we doing again? Oh yeah, playing poker. So this is Texas Hold'em, which is very easy to play. There isn't a tutorial, but if you're unsure, the help menu will go over all the rules. For gameplay, we have two modes to choose from, Pretty Mode and Free Play. They both offer exactly the same gameplay, but Free Play will allow you to choose your opponents from a pool of characters that you've previously unlocked. Pretty Mode is the main game mode where you'll unlock new characters. You'll be playing a set group of characters for each stage, however, you will need to win several games to progress to the next stage. Each game will start everyone out with $100. You can place your bets, fold, and raise as usual. Whoever is left with all the cash is the winner of that game. Each new win will earn you a puzzle piece that works to complete a picture for that stage. Once you've collected all of the puzzle pieces, you'll progress to the next stage and unlock more waifu to play with. As far as I can tell though, there is no real difference between any of the characters other than their appearance. The first stage requires only 4 puzzle pieces to advance, or in other words, 4 wins. The second stage requires 8 puzzle pieces, third stage 12, and so on. Now, as far as the AI goes, it's pretty simple and easy to manipulate. They don't ever bluff, and they'll easily fall for your bluff every single time. Watch how they bet, because the only time they will raise is when they have something somewhat decent. To maximize how much money you can sap out of your opponents, you'll need to carefully raise your bet slowly, and then finally scare them off into folding at the last second. Since each new game starts you with a crisp $100 bill, losing isn't really a big deal. You'll just start over again with another $100. But to exploit that rule further, you can simply retry a game as many times as you want until you get a decent hand. The trophies in the PlayStation 4 version are pretty simple. You'll be able to obtain them all sometime during the second stage. It's about a 1-hour platinum. Since you can't ever accumulate a massive cash pool in this game, that means there is no high score table this time. The online leaderboards is something I really liked about the first two games because it extends the replayability somewhat. The other thing I miss in this game is seeing the 3/4 view of each girl during gameplay. Instead, you'll only see their faces until the round is over. Furthermore, there is no gallery or CG area this time. If you're really into poker, you might enjoy this one more, but no customizable rules and a very simplistic AI make it a bit dull in that regard. However, the character art looks great, it's a pretty easy platinum, and MSRP is only $6, so you can't go too wrong there. But I would recommend the other two games over this one any day. Anyway guys, that's a quick look at Poker Pretty Girls Battle Fantasy World Edition for the PlayStation 4 and Nintendo Switch. Thanks for watching, until next time, I will see you later.